Hi everyone, I have November's project roundup. These are all the craft and DIY projects I completed last month, and some of the biggest projects I worked on last month. I don't have anything tangible to show you, but in the beginning of the month I had to refinish some furniture because my little girl was chewing on her crib, but the crib doesn't even belong to us, it belongs to my brother, and she was like chewing chunks of the wood out of her crib, and I was going to replace the crib for my brother, and it's discontinued, of course, so I had to do my best to repair it. I had to sand it down, completely sand it down to bare wood, the whole section that she had chewed on, restain it, refinish it. In the end, the repair job looked pretty good. My brother was satisfied with it. I didn't take any pictures. It was a nightmare. I just wanted it out of my house before she had a chance to destroy it again. So I gave him his crib back, and I bought her own crib so she could destroy it. And she did. Within 18 hours, she was chewing on that crib as well. So I made a fleece cover for the rail that she was chewing on. And it's a really simple no-sew project, and it only takes like 12 inches of fleece, which I had on hand. So I put it on just to see if it would help, and so far, so good. She hasn't chewed on it, or she hasn't done any more damage to the crib since I put it on there. So hopefully it stays that way. The other big project I worked on last month was two video projects, and I don't want to talk too much about this because I'm sure watching a YouTube video of somebody talking about making YouTube videos is incredibly boring, but there was two projects, kind of larger projects that I had been wanting to do for a while, but I'm kind of limited in my, you know, my skills and my technology and things like that, and I felt like I was at a point where I could do them, and I'm pretty happy with how they turned out. I know they're not perfect. But I like how they turned out, and I just want to give them a little plug. If you haven't seen them already, I did a day in the life video on Thanksgiving. It's about 20 minutes long, so I'm going to warn you. I think that's about average for day in the life videos, but it is 20 minutes long of basically just me yammering on. But I tried to make it entertaining, so you can check that out if you're interested. The other big project I worked on was Cookie Week, and that's actually going on right now. So Monday through Friday this week, I'm posting a new cookie video at 8 p.m. every night. And on Sunday, I posted a cookie baking tips video. So you can check those out also if you're interested. And sometimes I struggle to get like one cooking video up in a week. So having one every day was a big commitment, but I'm really happy that I did it. I love how they turned out. And now I have all my Christmas cookies in the freezer waiting to be baked. So that's awesome. So those are all my sort of intangible projects, and in front of me here I have my tangible projects. So the first thing I have is this baby blanket, and this is for a little boy. This is block stitch, and I just got this out of a stitch dictionary, and it's really easy, but I really like how it turned out. I think it's a good compromise between sort of a solid blanket and like a lacy, holey blanket. I like afghans with lots of holes in them, and I think babies do too. My little one loves to stick her fingers and her toes through the holes. But I think people who don't crochet kind of don't understand that a blanket full of holes can still be warm. So I thought this was a good compromise. I'm not gonna make a double crochet row after row blanket for somebody. I'm sorry. It's gonna have to be interesting to me if I'm gonna make it. But I thought, like I said, this is a good compromise. And as far as the yarn, it's for a little boy, but I didn't want to do just like a pastel blue. I don't think that's really the mom's style, but I don't really know what her style is, if that makes any sense. So I didn't want to assume what non-traditional color she would like for her baby. So I found this yarn. It's this Bernat Super Value, and the color is called Denim Rag, and it's kind of white and blue wrapped around together. Hopefully the lighting's good in this video. I'm using my new camera, but of course today's got to be like the rainiest, dreariest day, so I have these lamps on. I don't know if it's better with or without the lamp. Anyways, so I have this blanket. It's about 32 inches square, and as soon as I see her, I'll give it to her. I think her baby was born. It's for my neighbor, and I don't want to go knocking on her door. But as soon as I see her, I'll give her this blanket. Something else I made this month are these mittens. These are for my little one. She's 15 months now, so I had made the spiral baby mittens video. This is the same sort of pattern. I just started with a longer beginning chain and then I made them longer to fit her now larger hands, since her newborn mittens don't fit her anymore. And then I didn't do two colors, I just did one solid color. So we have those. And then I worked on a lot of ornaments. I participate in an ornament swap, so I was looking for some ideas for some ornaments and I came across these candy cane ornaments. And I showed these in my day in the life video, but they are just like coils. So you make your foundation chain and then you put three double crochets in each stitch and it just like coils onto itself. So I made this one where you put the red and the white together and I didn't really like how it turned out. But then there's this other one where you make two coils, one red and one white, and you twist them together. And this is how the pattern called for it to be, the length of it. But I think it's too short. By the time you get the curve here, it's just too short. So I made another one. I'm finally happy with this one, but unfortunately I forget what my beginning chain was. So it's more than the pattern calls for. I think the pattern called for 30 something, and this is probably like 45. And then I put the pipe cleaner in it. I still need to clip the pipe cleaner. I just need to get some scissors that are not my fabric shears to cut that. So I made these coils and then I made just a little short segment of the red and the white, just as a little ornament, not exactly a candy cane, maybe a peppermint stick or maybe just a decorative thing. And then I did this one in these sort of non-traditional Christmas colors. And then I went crazy and made a bunch in all different colors and I was playing around with the length and playing around with, you know, you can make them kind of short and squatty like that, or you can make them long and skinny like this. And I made some, these are mostly made in Red Heart Super Saver, so it's kind of a stiffer yarn. And then I made some in this sort of softer yarn. I think this is Caron Simply Soft. It's a little bit softer yarn. And I did some with two stitches instead of three stitches in each stitch. So I just made a whole bunch of these. And I think I'm going to do a tutorial on this as well, because this is incredibly easy and it only takes 5 yards of yarn, so a great stash buster and a good beginner project. So I did a beginner tutorial for my beginner's washcloth video and I've gotten some comments that I went too fast, so I want to try to do another beginner's tutorial and, you know, try to go slower and be more deliberate and do a better job. So I think that I will try to film this as a tutorial. I have one more little yarny thing here. I got a pom-pom maker and I was making some pom-poms. But if you look online, there's all sorts of directions on how you can make pom-poms into things, like mushrooms and like people's faces and skulls and ghosts and all sorts of things for Halloween. And this one was for a Christmas tree. I made it a little different than the directions say, and this was just like a practice one. So I might try to make another one and do a better job. But this is so cute, little pom-pom Christmas tree. And then the last thing I have are the ornaments that I actually finished for the swap that I'm doing. And these are made out of paper, and it's called quilling. My mom taught me how to do this when I was a kid. She had a bunch of supplies left over from, you know, whenever it was all the rage in the 70s. And so I had seen these snowflakes. They're usually not mounted, but I mounted them just to make them more stable since I have to mail these. Anyways, so she had this quilling paper, and what I ended up doing is, because I just need white anyway, I just cut strips of computer paper. And I think they turned out alright. So then I go to AC Moore, and I see that there's a whole section of quilling things now, so apparently quilling is popular again. It's also sometimes called paper filigree, but I think the new things I saw at AC Moore, they all have the word quilling on them. So I have a few different styles that I did, that one, and then this one. So, testing out the autofocus ability of my new camera. It's pretty nice. I think that's all the different, this one might be a different one. This one's a little bit mangled. Probably made this one a little bit too delicate. But those are all of my ornaments. I made 12 of them, but I repeated the design on some of them. I wanted to make each of them different, but these were incredibly time consuming. So I ended up doing some repeats. And then on here is just a little tag that says 2014, since I make different ornaments each year. So I put the year on them. So that's everything in November. I hope that you had a great November. Please leave me some comments down below letting me know what you worked on or what your plans for working on in December. And I will see you next month.